नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन टू एसेंशियल इलेक्ट्रिकल्स। इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ इंसुलेटर। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट व्हाट इज इंसुलेटर एंड डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज दैट योर इंसुलेटर शुड पजेस। सो दीज आर द फोर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ इंसुलेटर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस। सो दीज आर द इंसुलेटर विच आर जनरली यूज इन केस ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन और द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लाइन। द फर्स्ट वन इज पिन टाइप इंसुलेटर, the second one is suspension type insulator, the third is strain type insulator, and the fourth is shackle type insulator. So in today's lecture we are going to discuss how these kind of insulators are designed, in which voltage level this kind of insulator is generally used, and what is the special application of every insulator. Okay, so this is going to be very good video. So if you feel free, you can subscribe my channel and give thumbs up to this video. So let's get this lecture started. So let us first discuss about the pin type insulator. So we already know that these kind of insulators are the earliest development in case of overhead insulator. Okay, and that is why when the voltage is low, we can use pin type of insulator. Okay, so when we can say the voltage level is less than 33 kV, we can use pin type of insulator. Now this kind of insulator can be one type, it can be two type, it can be three part type insulators. Okay, and this is going to be depends upon the application voltage. So let's say in case of 33 kV we have to use three part type. Okay, so let's say in case of 11 kV system we generally use one part insulator. Okay, in case your insulator is one piece of properly shaped, and the material which is going to be used is either porcelain or glass. Okay, so as the leakage path of insulator is through its surface, so this surface is going to be the leakage path. It is desirable to increase the vertical length of the insulator for we can say the lengthening the leakage path. So if you want to increase the leakage path, we can increase the vertical distance. Okay, so we provide one, two or more range sheets, or we can say the petticoats on insulator body, to obtain longer leakage path. So in this figure you can see we have 1, 2, 3 range sheets, or also you can say it petticoats. Okay, so if you want to lengthening this leakage path, we can use multiple amount of petticoats. Okay, so this is also the figure of pin type of insulator. So in addition to that, range sheets or petticoats on insulators serve another purpose, and this another purpose is we use or we design this kind of insulator in such a way that your petticoats that while draining, the outer surface of range sheets becomes wet but the inner surface remain dry and non-conductive. And that is why you can see that when the rain drops right here, so your outer surface of the petticoats become wet, but this inner surface is going to be dry and non-conductive. Okay, and that is why this upper part will be bigger than the lower part. Okay, so there will be discontinuous part of conducting path through the damped pin insulator surface. So this is very much important, because in later we are going to define one term that is called flashover distance. Okay, so let us discuss about this only. In higher voltage system like 33 kV and 66 kV, the manufacturing of one part porcelain pin insulator becomes more difficult. Okay, because this is very much high voltage, 33 kV and 66 kV. So to design one pin insulator is become very much difficult, because a very thick single piece insulator, porcelain insulator, is not practical to manufacture. Okay, so what we can do in that case? So in that case we can use multiple part pin insulator, where some properly designed porcelain shells are fixed together by Portland cement. So here you can see that these two shells are connected with the help of Portland cement. So here you can find the cement. Okay, to form one complete insulator unit. Okay, so this unit, this is first unit, then second unit are connected with the help of Portland cement. Okay, so in that way, in case of 33 kV, we have to use multiple pin type insulators. Okay, and they are connected with the help of cement. So let us talk about some of the design consideration of pin type insulator. So the live conductor attached to the top of the fin insulator, which is at the live potential. So your conductor is going to be placed at this point, okay, and this conductor is going to be fixed with the help of wire. Now we fix the bottom part of the insulator to the supporting structure of, we can say, the earth potential. Okay, so obviously your tower is going to be right here. Okay, so your tower is going to be right here, and the insulator has to withstand the potential stresses between the conductor and earth, because at this point the potential will be zero and this point the potential will be maximum. So all the stress will going to be across your pin type insulator. So your insulating material, it should be such that it should have to withstand the stresses of very high. Okay, so the shorter distance between the conductor, because your conductor will going to pass like this, okay, it will going to pass something like this. This will be your conductor. So the shortest distance between the conductor and earth surrounding the insulator body, along which your electric discharge may take place through the air, is known as flashover distance. So the flashover distance is nothing but from here to here to here to here. This is known as the flashover distance. Okay, so this distance should be as maximum as possible. Okay, so the shortest distance between your conductor to the earth surface, so your tower is connected to the earth, so we can say this is also at the ground potential. Okay, so minimum path between your conductor and earth surface is known as flashover distance. Okay, and this distance from this conductor to earth, or we can say this tower, is known as puncture voltage. Okay, this is known as puncture voltage, and this known as flashover distance. Okay, so these two definitions are very important. So these are the design consideration, because when the insulator is wet, so let me clear all these things first. Okay, just a second. So when the insulator is wet, so let's say in case of rain, this insulator is going to be wet, its outer surface become almost conducting. Okay, so this wet part will going to be become conducting, hence flashover distance of insulator is going to be decreased, because this part is conducting. So first the flashover distance was here to here, now it is here to here. So the flashover distance is going to be decreased. So the design of insulator is going to be such a way that decrease of flashover distance is minimum when the insulator is going to be wet. Okay, so this distance is going to be minimum. Okay, and that is not ideal condition. Our design consideration should be such that your flashover distance should be as high as possible. Okay, so this will be the criteria while designing the pin type insulator. Now one more criteria that we have to consider while designing the pin type insulator is that that's why the upper part, or we can say the petticoats that we are going to provide in case of pin type insulator, is in the shape of umbrella. Okay, so it can protect the less rest part of your lower insulator. So here you can see this part is a shape is like umbrella. So your lower insulator, so let's say this part, is going to be safe from the rain. Okay, so this is the first design consideration of your pin type insulator. If we talk about the second, the rain sheets or the petticoats are made in such a way that they should not disturb the voltage distribution. Okay, so voltage distribution is also considerable, and they are so designed that their subsurface at the right angle to the your, we can say, the electromagnetic light lines of the force. So these angles also should be considerable while designing any kind of pin type insulator. Okay, so these are the design consideration that we have to take in mind while designing the pin type insulator. Now let us discuss about the suspension type insulator. So here it is. So in higher voltage, or we can say the voltage beyond 33 kV, because in previous slides I have told you that a pin type insulator is used in case of less than 33 kV. So beyond 33 kV, it is uneconomical to use pin type insulator because of the size and the weight of insulator become more. So what we can do? So handling and replacing bigger size single unit insulator are difficult, and that is why for overcoming these kind of difficulties, suspension type insulator was developed. Okay, now there are so many advantages of using suspension type insulator that we are going to discuss also. In suspension type insulator, the number of insulators are connected in series to form a string. Okay, so here you can see in the figure that so many insulating discs are connected in series. Okay, so the line conductor is carried by the bottommost of the insulator. So where should be your conductor? So conductor is going to be right here. Okay, so the conductor is going to be right here, and this part is going to be at your topmost of the tower. Okay, this is connected with your topmost of the tower. So this kind of insulator is known as suspension type insulator. Each insulator or the suspension ring is called disc insulator because of the shape is like the disc. So this is known as the disc or the disc insulator. Now for application of, let's say, in case of 220 kV, how much disc will be needed? In case of 440, in case of 765 transmission line, how much disc will be needed? That will be going to be discussed in next lecture, because the string efficiency is very much important topic, and I don't want to take a few minutes to discuss the string efficiency. That is why the suspension type insulator and the distribution of voltage across the disc and the string efficiency. Okay, so that topic we are going to discuss in next lecture. Okay, so let us discuss all other the things that we have to consider in case of suspension type insulator. So let us discuss some of the advantages of suspension type insulator. So each suspension disc is designed for the normal voltage rating. Let's say it is 11 kV. So normally it is 11 kV, but for higher voltage rating, it should be 15 kV. So by using different number of disc, a suspension string can be made suitable for any voltage level. Okay, so by multiplying this disc, okay, we can use your suspension type insulator for any kind of voltage level. Okay, if any of the disc insulator in a suspension string is damaged, it can be replaced much easily. So let's say I am having a 33 kV system, and in 33 kV system generally 3 discs are needed. Okay, and one of the disc is punctured due to the voltage flashover. So in that case, I have to replace only one disc rather than just replacing the whole insulator. So this is one of the advantage of suspension type insulator. So replacement can be very easy. The third advantage is mechanical stress on suspension insulator is less because your lines hanged on a flexible suspension string. Okay, so obviously, let's say this is your tower and your suspension type insulator is strung right here. Okay, so this will be your first disc, second disc, third disc, fourth disc, let's say something like this, and your conductor is right here. Okay, this is your conductor. So when the heavy wind condition will be there, your conductor will oscillate in this way. Okay, your conductor will oscillate in this way, and with your conductor, this insulator is also going to be oscillate. Okay, so there will be no any mechanical strength on the insulator. That is why mechanical stress in case of suspension type insulator is less. But in case of pin type insulator, your insulator is fixed on, we can say, on your tower. So when the wind are very heavy, in that case your conductor has to face mechanical stress, and that is going to be that is not going to be helpful. Okay, so mechanical stress on suspension type insulator is less. Okay, the next is conductors may be safe from the lightning, obviously, because the height of the tower is right here in case of suspension, but your conductor is very much below at your the peak of the tower. Okay, so your conductor is going to be safe from the lightning. So these are some of the advantages in case of the suspension type insulator. Now let us discuss the next is strain type insulator. See here you can see the strain type insulator. So when the suspension string is used to sustain extraordinary tensile load of the conductor, it is referred as string insulator. Okay, now there is specific application of strain type or the string type insulator is when there is a dead end or there is a sharp corner in transmission line, the line has to sustain a great tensile load of the conductor, okay, or we can say the strain. In that case, this kind of strain type insulators are generally used. So this is one of the important question that is going to be asked in many examination, that when the dead end is there or there is a sharp corner, which kind of insulator is generally used? So your answer should be strain type insulator. Okay, so I hope you remember this question also. So in many ways, when the transmission line is a long transmission line, the path is going to be straightforward. Okay, so there is no need to use strain type insulator. We can use strain type insulator, but there will be beneficial if we use at the dead end or there is a sharp corner. A strain insulator must have considerable mechanical strength as well as the necessarily electrical insulating properties. Okay, so I think this is enough for the strain type insulator. Now let us discuss about the shackle type insulator. Here you can see the figure of shackle type insulator. So it is also known as shackle or spool kind of insulator, or you can say the reel type insulator. It is generally used in the beginning or at the end of the low voltage distribution system. Okay, or when the line takes at the sharp turn. Okay, it is also can be used at the sharp turn, but mostly the strain type insulators are used as the dead end and using the while using in the turn. Okay, so shackle is somewhat used at the low voltage distribution network. It is also known as reel type insulator. So it is reel shaped with a hole at the center. So here you can see there is a hole inside this insulator at the center through which the bolt is going to be passed. This here you can see the bolt is passed right here. It is fitted with a U-clamp, and this is U-clamp, and the U-clamp is fitted across the cross arm. Okay, this will be the cross arm that will be going to attach with your transmission tower. Okay, so conductor is kept on the groove provided on the central portion and tied with the help of the soft binding wire. Okay, so this kind of conductor or insulator, sorry, not conductor, is known as shackle type, spool type, or the reel type insulator. Okay, so the tapered hull of spool insulator distribute the load more evenly and minimize the possibility of the breakdown when the heavily loaded. Okay, so this is all about your pin type, suspension type, strain type, and the shackle type insulator. I hope you understand for what application we have to select what kind of insulator. If you have any doubt regarding today's lecture, you can tell me in the comment section or you can contact me directly. You can feel free to subscribe my channel and like this video. In next lecture, we are going to discuss about the voltage distribution in case of suspension type insulator and what is the string efficiency. So yes, thank you so much. See you guys next time.